So something else that gets asked a lot when we talk about lupines and what they're like compared to huskies or other wolf dogs or, is trainability, and can they go off lead, and can you do this and can you do that? And lupines are incredibly trainable. They are some of the smartest dogs I've ever known in both trainability wise but also common sense brain, which is unusual. You quite often don't get both, you get one or the other. Collies are a prime example of this. Most of them are incredibly trainable, but they don't have much in the way of common sense smarts. Like if you threw their ball over a cliff, they're just going to run after it and get it. They're not going to stop and think, hang on, no, I'm going to go splat. So, and you get a lot of dogs like livestock guardian breeds, for example, who have a lot of common sense brains. They're very self-sufficient, but they aren't necessarily the most trainable in the traditional sense. So it's really lovely having dogs that have both of those traits. Now, the thing that lets a lot of people down with a lot of dog breeds is that they don't let their dogs mature before they start thinking, oh, I can't do it. You know, you can't train this, you can't train that. So as you'll notice here, we're walking through the park at the moment. So this is a public park, anybody can use it. There's also a hell of a lot of rabbits around here. We get horses from the local yards as well. So both Millie and Bella are on their leads. Bella's in season as well at the moment, so obviously we're not letting her off in public places anyway. But Toki's off her lead. I'm not keeping the hugest amount of attention on her because I know she's very sensible. She knows where she goes, where she isn't. I know I can get her to recall, you know, on a single command straight away. I know that she'll leave chasing things on a cue. But she's 8 years old. She's a very sensible, mature dog. She wasn't like this until she was about 4. And that's what comes with mental development and maturity. Toki, steady. Good girl. Whereas both Millie and Bella, I mean, Millie, gosh, she's only just a year old now, so she's still very much a teenager. She's a puppy still, really. Bella, she's 2.5, so she's still pretty young, really. Although she's now physically and sexually mature, she's still got a little bit of the baby brain. Little bit. She's almost there now. She's pretty good off lead. But I couldn't trust her not to go chase a rabbit, for example. Or a horse if it was, you know, they were cantering along or something like that. If it was walking, she wouldn't be bothered. But if it was running, that's a little bit different. So she's still not quite there maturity level like Toki is yet either. And that's something that a lot of people neglect when they are looking at training their dogs and the trainability of their dogs. They wait. Quite often a lot of people leave it until they are teenagers before they start training, because generally puppies are quite well behaved. They don't have the confidence to run off and you know, go see another dog or chase or something that's too far away, because they're babies. They don't have that confidence yet. And then they hit adolescence and all of a sudden they start being quite naughty, well, in our eyes anyway, and they're running off to other dogs and not listening, and you know, dogs that may have been very well behaved previously suddenly become absolute monkeys. And it's just teenagers. It's the same as human teenagers. They go through a lot of hormonal swings that can affect their behaviour. But a lot of people then give up with a dog and think, oh no, you know, I can't train it, that's it, game over. If I'd done that with Toki, she'd never be off lead, because when she was the same age as Millie, she was everywhere. She was all over trying to get to everybody, you know, trying to chase squirrels, trying to do this, trying to do that. She was all over the shop. Whereas now, she's absolutely perfect. You know, this is a dog that I would, if I would was brave enough to, you know, would walk through a field of sheep with her off of a lead, and I know she wouldn't do anything. Obviously, I would never do that because it's very stupid and you should never risk your dog's life like that, but that's how confident I am in the dog she is now. And it's a huge difference from when she was an adolescent. So mental maturity, when you look at training, is incredibly important. You can't just go, oh, nope, you know, my dog's 18 months old, 2 years old, that's it, give up, can't do it, you know, it's never going to be a reliable off leash or anything like that. You have to let them mentally mature to catch up with what you're asking them to do. It's really vitally important. Good girls. Toki, wait. Good girl. Come on then. Go home now.